from 1 month to 13, no, to 19, are invited up to help in the choir. You just have to be willing. You don't have to be a choir member. You have to be, no, ma'am, that's not you. Somebody stood up there old as me.
You have your money, Morgan.
So if any other young people would like to join the ones that are already there, and let's give a round of applause to those who have willingly.
The day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Let's show God some praise this morning. Let's start this morning off right. That's a little tired. Come on. Let's give God some praise this morning. We're going to start our service this morning with scripture from Deacon William Cobb and then prayer from Deacon Gary Hart.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Oh, come on now. Praise the Lord. Let me try. There we go. Praise the Lord, everybody. God is good. All right. That's what I'm talking about. He is worthy to be praised, I tell you. He woke us up this morning and just allowed us to see another day. Ain't that good? Okay, I'm coming out of Philippians 4 down to 7. The Bible said, rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. Let your moderation be main unto all men. The Lord is at hand. Now listen to that. The Lord is at hand. Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. And the peace which passes all understanding shall keep your heart and minds through Jesus Christ. Finally, my brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, and whatsoever things are good report. If there is anything virtuous, and there is anything, and any praise on these things, may the Lord add a blessing to the reading of his word. Amen. We have prayer. Let us stand, please. We have prayer by Deacon Hart. Come on, Dean.
Let us pray, church. Father God, we come this morning just to say thank you, Lord. Lord, we thank you for this day, Lord, and what it's going to bring us, Lord. Lord, we thank you for our lying down last night and our earlier rising to this new day we've never seen before. Father God, we thank you for the traveling grace and mercy that you've given us, Lord, to come out to the house of prayer. Lord, we ask you to bless us, dear Lord, each and every family that is represented here, dear Lord. Dear Lord, we know there are problems that we're going through, Lord, but we ask you, Lord, to help see us through, Lord. Lord, we ask you to bless each and every one, dear Lord, in a special way. Bless our pastor and his family, Lord, in a special way, Lord. Lord, we ask you to now, Lord, to come into this service, dear Lord, and help us to lift your name in praise, dear Lord, that it shall touch somebody's heart in a special way, Lord. Lord, we ask you to bless our musicians, dear Lord, bless our director, dear Lord, and bless this service again is our prayer in your name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. All right, choir. I'm only him will be on 262.
Yeah.
Amen.
Thank you.
that saves a way.
Okay.
Oh, happy day. Oh, happy day. When Jesus was, he wiped my sins away.
Let's give these young people a hand one more time. I have a question to ask. Will a man rob God? Yet ye have robbed me, but ye say, wherein have we robbed thee? In tithes and offerings. Ye are cursed with a curse, for ye have robbed me, even this whole nation. Bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be meat in mine house, and prove me now herewith, saith the Lord of hosts, if I will not open you the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing, that there shall not be room enough to receive it. White Rock, it's time to give back a portion of what the Lord has blessed you with for use in his service. Let us please stand and face the inside. Thank you. You're now in the hands of the doorkeepers.
Thank you.
I know when we came in this morning, we probably didn't get an opportunity to say hello to everyone that we wanted to speak to this morning. So we're going to take time right now to meet and greet, just a few minutes, if we'd all just stand up and walk over and say hello to someone that you hadn't spoken to already. May the Lord bless this whole process.
Amen.
Pastor, did you say it was $10 for the last one?
$10.
Who sits down, $10.
Let's see. Like a cookie cat. Butter. Amen.
If Kenneth would just see me after service. Will the Lord cast off forever? And will he be favorable no more? In his mercy clean, gone forever, doth his promise fail evermore? Hath God forgotten to be gracious? Hath he in anger shut up his tender mercies? And I said, this is my infirmity, but I will remember the years of the right hand of the Most High. I will remember the works of the Lord. Surely I will remember thy wonders of old. I will meditate also on thy work, the talk of thy doings. Thy way, O God, is in the sanctuary. Who is so great a God as our God? Soldiers. the doorkeepers will now seat the remaining members and guests at this time. Thank you.
Thank you.
delivered, and set free. Amen. We're going to wait until our other family and guests are seated. Then we're going to come with a twofold prayer for altar prayer this morning. As you probably read in the paper again on Friday or Saturday, that another person was shot and killed in the city of Chester. I don't know how much worse it can get before it starts to get better. But one of our own, Corey, that was his uncle, I believe, we're going to have him come, and I want the teenagers and then surrounded by the adults to come and stand with him this morning. Why don't you come, church family, teenagers? These are difficult times. Come on, White Rock. Whether we want to admit it or not, our city is in a crisis. A crisis like we've never seen before. Thank you for coming, church family. There was a time in my life when I felt safe in my own neighborhood. There was a time when I felt safe among my own people. When I grew up in Huntsville, Texas, if I had to go from the east side of town to the west side of town, the middle section didn't belong to us. I didn't feel comfortable going through that middle section. But when I reached the east or the west end, I felt okay. But now, I don't care whether you go to the east end of town, the west end of town, or the middle of town, we seem to have problems. And it's with ourselves. Heavenly Father, we come first this morning with a prayer of thanksgiving. We thank you that you woke us up this morning and started us on our way. We thank you, you allowed the angel to watch over our bed last night as we slumbered and slept. We thank you, God, for a reasonable portion of health and strength. We thank you for everything that you've done for us. We pray now, God, that you'd bless this young man. Heal his broken heart. Let him know right now that you've not left him nor forsaken him, that you're with him and will be with him forevermore. Bless his family. Keep them in your care. Keep this young man strong. Let him know that you would give him the strength to get through each and every day. Sometimes he'll feel hurt and lonely, but you'll be right there. We pray for our city once again. We pray for the young men and women in the city who are counting your way unholy. Haven't even heard your word. We pray that you would turn them around. Help us to turn them around before it's too late. We need you right now, God. Right now we need you, God. We need you like we have never, ever needed you before. We need you to come inside the walls of this city and bless from the youngest to the oldest that we will start to listen to your way. Bless us now, God. Bless this young man. We thank you for listening to our prayers. We thank you for your love. We thank you for your kindness. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you, God. This we say in Jesus' name, amen, 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 amen. It's all right. Gonna be all right. Going to be all right. I think he said that wasn't so bad after all. Amen. We're going to go into our morning lesson. As all of you are aware, this is Palm Sunday. I am going to read several scripture, but you need to know already that this is not my Bible. There are three notes on this page, and the reason this is not my Bible and there are only three notes on this page is because I was rushing Annette so much this morning that when I left home, I left my whole briefcase, my Bible, my notes, my everything. I think God was getting me back. I think that was payback. Yep. But there is a Bible in the house. I don't know whose this is. It was in the deacon's office, and it had a nice cover on it. But the cover was going to get in my way. It had some materials in it, but I put those to the side, too. So if you recognize this Bible, you can get it back after church. But something tells me you might not have had this Bible in your hand for a while, because there was a lesson folded up in there that was a while ago. Now then, go with me, if you would, to St. Matthew, the 21st chapter, beginning at the first verse. St. Matthew, the 21st chapter, beginning at the first verse. We will also take a scripture from Mark, the 11th chapter, and the 8th verse, and we will also read a verse of St. Luke, the 19th chapter. And I'll tell you the verse when I find it. And the 35th verse. The second one was St. Mark, the 11th chapter, beginning at the first verse. We were at First Faith the other night, and I started to read the scripture, but before I started, I said, now, if I copied this wrong out of the computer and the wrong verse, White Rock will tell me. I was true. That was right. We are going to read the 8th verse of that 11th chapter of Mark. We're not going to read the whole thing, although it's very much verbatim to what we will be reading in St. Matthew. So let's get started. And when they drew nigh unto Jerusalem and were come to Bethphage, unto the Mount of Olives, then sent Jesus two disciples, saying unto them, go into the village over against you, and straightway ye shall find an ass tied and a colt with her. Loose them and bring them unto me. And if any man say aught unto you, ye shall say, the Lord hath need of them, and straightway he will send them. All this was done that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the prophet, saying, tell ye the daughter of Zion, behold,